Hi friends, I am Bharat Kumar Ladda. I am from ICBM School of Business Excellence. I am here to explain you people about building strong brands. Building strong brands. Build brand positioning, brand name selection, brand sponsorship, and brand name brand development. What is a brand? A brand is a distinguished symbol, mark, logo, and the name, word, sentence, or a combination of all these used by the companies to distinguish their products from the competitors or the others in the market. Legal protection given to a brand name is called as trademark. Brand positioning. Brand positioning. Marketers need to position their brand clearly in the target customer mind. Brand positioning refers to an act of designing the company's offerings and image in such a way that it occupies a distinctive place in the minds of the target customers. A brand can be bettered or positioned by associating the name with the desirable benefits. There are some of the successful brands in the market which have been positioned in such a best way that they are positioned in the, showing the benefits, like such as Volvo, showing its safety, FedEx, guaranteed on time, Nike, its performance. Now, coming to the brand name selection, a good name can add greatly to a product success. Finding the best brand's name is a difficult task. Branding begins with the product benefits and its target customers or the market. Desirable qualities for a brand name are like: it should suggest something about the product's benefits and qualities. It should be easy to pronounce, recognize, and remember. The brand name should be distinctive. It should be capable of registration and it should be legally protection. There should be a legal protection. The name should be translated easily into the foreign languages. Next, brand sponsorship. Brand sponsorship. A manufacturer has 4 brand sponsorship options. The product may be launched as national brands, private brands, licensed brands, and co-brands. National brands. They have a long dominated and retail scene. National brands are owned and promoted usually by large manufacturers. Private brands. Private brands are the brands in which they are controlled and marketed by retailers. Most of the times, they carry the name of the retailers on the products. These brands are generally created by huge manufacturers who supply to the retailers, who puts his name on it before selling the product. It is also called as private label. Okay. Advantages of the private brands. What are the advantages of private brands? We can say like, gives freedoms and flexibility in pricing. Product attributes and quality can be easily controlled. Generally have higher margins. Manufacturers, promotions cost are minimum, very minimum. And coming to the licensing agreements, allows a company which market their products or services to rent a brand from a brand owner is also called as licensor. The responsibility of a licensor is to produce, promote, and distribute the product while the licensor gets royalty for its brand. On coming to the co-branding, the practice of using the established brand names of two different companies on the same product is also called as co-branding. Co-branding refers to the process when two brands come together for alliance and a brand product together to utilize the synergies between the two brands. Then coming to the brand development. And brand development, a company has 4 choices when it comes to the brand development. It can be introduced as line extension, brand extension, multi-brands, and new brands. Line extension. Extending an existing brand's name to a new forms, colors, size, ingredients, or flavors of an existing product category. A company might introduce line extensions as a low cost, low risk, and way to introduce the product, new product. And coming to the brand extension, extending your existing brand name to new product categories. A brand extension extends to the current name or to modify the product in a new category. Brand extension can be is given in a new product instant recognition and faster acceptance. It also saves the high advertising cost usually required to build a new product, new brand name. Coming to the multi-brands, companies often market many different brands in the given target market, in the given product category. Multi-branding offers a way to establish different features that appeal to different customer segments. Now, new brands. The company might believe that the power of existing new brand name is waning. So, a new brand name is needed. Or, it may create a new brand name when it enters into a new product category for which none of these current brands' name are appropriate. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.